Noted conservative attorney George Conway normally sticks to 280 characters to troll President Trump on Twitter. He's called him pathological, a narcissistic sociopathic demagogue, a cancer, a liar, and honestly, that's just this week. But today, the Trump critic, who just happens to be the husband of one of President Trump's most loyal advisors, Kellyanne Conway, made a rare public appearance. As CNN's Tom Foreman reports, it was not without some subtle and not so subtle digs at President Trump.
Now, if people were to get indicted or not indicted on the basis of whether the president likes them, we wouldn't have a republic. We'd have a banana republic.
He did not use the president's name, but in an extremely rare public speaking appearance, George Conway tore into Donald Trump just the same.
And the president has suggested that members of his own Justice Department should be locked up for investigating the president.
Conway blasted Trump over his ideas on justice, his attacks on freedom of the press.
That's a problem of a quite different order of magnitude. You can't have a free country with that.
Conway has freely attacked the president for a long time, despite being married to top Trump advisor Kellyanne Conway. Just this past week, tweeting Trump is a fraud and an embarrassment, an inveterate liar, a narcissistic sociopathic demagogue. Referring to the president's repeated unproven claims of being a great student, Conway has tagged Trump summa cum liar, noting Trump's approach is to virtually never tell the truth when there is an opportunity to tell a lie, even offering an armchair diagnosis. It's pathological. It's an illness. The president has brushed him off before.
You mean Mr. Kellyanne Conway?
Suggesting George Conway's barbs are meaningless.
He's just trying to get publicity for himself.
Kellyanne Conway clearly squirms when confronted about differences with her husband, at times suggesting such questions are fundamentally sexist.
First of all, I would ask you that if you were a man and
no,
your wife
wouldn't.
I would.
But George Conway continues to revel in the role of Trump troll in chief.
Plus, I kind of like the fact that you can tweet at rich public officials without fear of retribution in the courts.
Now, remember, this is not a liberal. This is a guy who's as conservative as they come. He simply feels that the rule of law is being undermined so much by this White House that he just has to speak out. However, it has been very rare that he does speak out. We see him tweet. Every now and then you see him quoted. Very rarely does he speak up. But boy, did he speak up today, and I'm sure they're none too happy about it at the White House Communications Office.
I'm sure. Tom Foreman, thanks so much. Appreciate it.